Hi all, Hal here with more 7 Days to Die, and you might notice some of the things that I've used to have out here in the courtyard are no longer here. We did replace the bars over here in that back corner, so there's no more blocks over there. I do have the raised firing positions all the way around now, and I'm starting to work on a tower in the middle of my my base. For a couple of reasons. One, I kind of need one. The other one is that I was out looting, let me show you here, and I picked up the two lights that I had made, but I'd also had, I found while I was out looting, because I took a bunch of cars apart, I grabbed a couple of batteries, and I mean they were just absolutely low quality. One of them was I think like quality 5 or something. But thankfully, that doesn't matter when you're using them for lights. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually put some lights up over here in the tower. I think I want this to go one more block like so. And then what we did is we left an opening down at the bottom on both sides so you can walk through down here. And I'm going to put a ladder up into the middle as well. Mainly because, let's see, I want you guys there and there. Right? Yeah. Mainly because what I'm going to be doing is having a ladder up here, because I want to have the lights set up so that we can have them looking out over the walls. Alright, so so let's go ahead and put you guys back for a second. So we're gonna do one this way. Does that work that way? Yeah, well, you know it does. It goes through the walls. Nice. Alright, so let's go ahead and drop this stuff over here. Yeah, and I really haven't even had a chance to do anything with with any of my resources. As you saw, I still have basically a full inventory at this point. And then we actually, because what I was thinking was to do that and that, and this way we have light all the way around the base now. Okay, that actually works really well. I do need to make a few more frames. Go ahead and make 10. And what we're going to do with these is we're actually going to build a cap up here. And then we're going to have on, I think, I don't know, maybe we'll just build a bridge straight across. That might work a little bit better. If we're going to build a bridge, then we'll need to do, see, because I was thinking I was going to do a ladder up through the middle of this, but what I might do instead is to put a bridge in right there. Yeah, I think we're going to do that. Of course, now that I've gotten myself up here, you know, I wasn't really thinking about getting myself down easily. I'm already dealing with one broken ankle. I do not need to be dealing with another. So, we're going to go ahead and do this easy way. Alright, and there we go. And we're down. Okay. So yeah, basically what we have is a the ability to walk through here, and part of the reason for this is because I want it set up so that if the zombies do make it into the courtyard, well, you know, let's be fair here, it's not an if, but when they do make it into the courtyard, I want it set up so that they're not going to basically just destroy the place. Okay, so that should go there. So it's gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hey, nice. We can actually get away with putting it there. Yes, let's make a few more frames. We're gonna make, I don't know, another... Let's make another 50. Makes it nice and easy. So, happy Friday, everybody. I hope you enjoyed your week and that the weekend is shaping up to be good. I know I'm fairly excited for this weekend. So, as some of you know, I started recently recording with the Broken Ankle crew. So, yeah, that's something. This is actually the second week with them. So, tomorrow we will be recording some more fun end games. For the folks that are interested in joining with what's going on with the Skyrim build, make sure you reach out to Rongo. It is his server, but they are looking, they're always looking for more people to be on the community server. But we're also looking for people to help out. The community that he's got over there is simply awesome and ridiculously amazing as it is. So, yeah, if you're interested in helping out with the big build that everyone's working on right now, make sure you reach out to Rongo and let him know. Alright, so, let's see here. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this off, because it's really just irritating the crap out of me. Too much light. Okay. And then, do I have any ramps? No. We'll go ahead and make one though. There we go. Look at that. Nice and simple, right? Okay. And then, what we want is we're actually going to take these out. And we're going to replace these with the regular square blocks so that we can do that. Now it should be okay all the way across. I hope. Of course, first time I use it, watch, it's going to like collapse and kill everybody or something. Alright, so we now have our walkway out. I'm wondering if I should do something against zombies over on the side, but I'm not sure how that would work out. So we're going to leave it as it is right now. Basically, if I get overtaken here, we're pretty much done anyway. So yeah, so we'll let that go. This should be good. We'll go grab... Do I have a... I should have a hammer or a wrench in one of these things. I've got so much stuff. I haven't been paying attention to everything. Oh, look, I actually had 1,000 wood in here already. Imagine that. Okay, so let's go ahead and... I'm just going to drop some of the stuff. Oh yeah, and I ended up finding two engines while I was taking those cars apart as well. It's kind of nice, actually. The cars were really profitable this time. I don't generally get good luck when I'm taking the cars apart, so... Actually... You are brass. Anything else that's actually brass right now? No. Okay. So one of the things that I've been doing off-camera is I did a little bit of work. We've dug down a bit further. Let's go for the bolt hole area. So it goes pretty far down there now. Lots of brass-like items. So it's always a good thing. Look at that. Okay. So let me show you what we've been working on downstairs. I think we have a ladder all the way down now. This is how I broke my ankle again in the game. Yay, all the way down. Okay. So this is where we are right now, and as far as I can tell, we still have not hit bedrock, but we have to be fairly close. Wait, I just put all that lumber away, didn't I? Yep. That's not good. Okay. So before we go any further, we want to go get the lumber because we need ladders. Almost trapped myself down there. Oh, that would have been bad. So yeah, this is basically what I've been working on. I'm trying to get this ready in time for the day 14 horde. Because I have a feeling that we're actually going to have to fall back to the bunker itself. Speaking of, since we are already here, let's go ahead and do this. And what we're gonna do is let's go. I'm gonna save you the tediousness that is the mining in this game. Oh, I still need to make ladders. Okay. Well, drats. Okay. And all that lumber's upstairs. All that lumber's upstairs. Oh. See? Can't tell which side they're on. It sounds like they're actually over here. Where are they? Ah. Random wandering horde. We've been getting a lot of those lately. I do think that Mad Mole's fix for the perpetual hordes, the infinite hordes, were to give us the continuously, after you get through a certain day, you just get random horde every day. Because I don't think I've ever seen. I mean, we basically are getting a random heat map horde, well, a random spawn horde like this, once or twice a day. And I really don't want to waste time or ammo on those guys because we are starting to run out of resources. Oh, so I think I may have to do a quick cut from here. You know what? Oh man, I still haven't made. Yes, I still haven't made the spiked club. Oh well, you only live once, right? I just hate fighting zombies when I have the sprained ankle. Because if I fall, I'm pretty much dead. Well, that was nice of her. She took the arrow for you, buddy. You should thank her. That was really nice of her for you, right? Alright, you're actually dead. It's too bad I can't loot you from here. Alright, well, that was messy. I'm gonna have to go down and fix all of that again. Well, I know what I'm doing tomorrow. Oh, right. Well, at least we have, we've got our light tower in, our crops are growing, which, by the way, that tiered garden thing works really, really well. As you can see, we do have the corn growing into its max level. We have the potatoes that are growing. We have goldenrod, and I threw another piece of goldenrod over here just because I had it. Figured, might as well use it. Just helps us get stuff faster. So the next couple of days in game, what I'm going to be doing is basically just recycling the corn and potatoes until one of these fields is all corn and potatoes, and the other field is going to be coffee, and goldenrod. I'd plant the chrysanthemum if I could, but they still haven't given us the ability to make those in the seeds, so. Which is kind of sad. But it is what it is, and we will continue on with the way we are going. Alright, so that's the tower, that's this. Ah, yes, we're going to go grab more lumber. Because I still need to make more ladders. And we're going to start replacing the paper-thin metal. Alright, so... that's good. Let's just go ahead and craft what we can. It's actually faster to go up this way. Come on, get me off the ladder. Thank you. Oh, so yeah, eventually I'm going to replace that entire roof section. With what's going on in the game, it's kind of annoying. I mean, it looks great the way it is and all, but yeah. Not worth the hassle, so. Okay, so... and this is why we were replacing this stuff. Because it's basically one-hit wonder stuff. Should I not? Oh, I don't have anything to upgrade with. See, I'm just losing stuff all over the place, aren't I? Alright, so... was it in here? Yes, there we go. My last wrench. Don't ask me why I had aviator goggles on my hotbar. Come on, why are you not? Come on, up we go. Thank you. Oy. It's definitely been one of those days, right? Alright, so... next alpha update for 7 Days to Die. Looks like we're going to get some interesting things brought in. I think I mentioned it before, one of the changes that we're going to see is that the casino tokens actually scrap down to brass now. Has not been put into the game yet, but I am very excited to see it. I'm hoping that they get it in sooner than later. Mainly because of the fact that brass has gotten a lot harder to come by. Or I shouldn't say it's been harder to come by. We're getting probably about the same amount that we were before Alpha 13 and everything. Alpha 14 now. but one of the things that we've seen is that with the changes to the recipes, specifically the output, it's gotten a lot more expensive to use firearms now, which is fine. I mean, it needs to be balanced against everything else in the game. But the ammo cost itself is really ridiculous, so. I had somebody ask me why I wanted to upgrade all of this. It's like, well, why don't you just make it stronger inside? And I'm like, yeah, it works. But we've got the day 14 horde coming up, and I am really, really worried about the durability of the bunker. I should have already moved into concrete, but I've been having problems getting enough resources together to make the forges that I need. And since I'm spending so much time running back and forth, and now, you know, my in-game character ankle keeps breaking, I'm really just running out of the time to get things done. And that's where the big problem for me is concrete, so. So what we're doing then is just gonna hopefully nip the whole thing in the bud and not have to worry about it at all. At least that's the idea, right? We'll see how well it actually works out. One of the other things that I do want to do in here as well is to put in a door. Well, I'm thinking about putting a vault door like right here. So even if they do get in, they still have to go through the vault door as well. And the rest of it should be stable enough to support its own weight. We're gonna take the rest of this out. Yeah, it would be. I think I have a claw hammer somewhere too. I should probably grab. That would make this much faster. Oops, that was almost a bad thing. Not that it would have really have mattered at the end of the day, but you know. If you're gonna do it, you may as well do it right. A little bit more upgrading here. Oh, that's not good. So we're gonna get most of this done. We're gonna end up being one short. No, well, interesting. Wasn't expecting that. Okay. Yeah, it's just a shame that the other stone types, like the flagstone and the brick, aren't as durable as the cobblestone. Granted, you do have to do a lot more to cobble, and you use a lot more resources in placing it, but eh. It'd still be nice to have an alternative besides cobble or the cement line. Alright, so we need to go down to grab some more plant fibers. I think we have a few left. Do we not have any plant fiber left? Oh, we have to have some plant fiber. I had like 500 of it. Did I really use it all? Huh. I'm trying to think of what I would have used it for. So I don't think I made cobblestone frames recently, except for the ones that I've got in the inventory. Come on. There it is. See? Not going completely crazy yet. Yeah, well, we'll do 50. 50 is a good thing. And then once we have this all sorted out, I am going to put another set of bars. Actually, I think I have them. I have some. Yeah, I do. Awesome. So while we're here, let's go ahead and do that. See, slowly getting the projects done. Alright. Oh man, really? You were not scheduled for today. I thought you were scheduled for, like, tomorrow. And it's way over there. Do I want to go for it is the question. Yeah. How much inventory do I have? I've got room. Okay. Don't know if I have the speed to make it or not, but yeah, no. I don't have the speed to make it until this foot heals. Oh, it's over there. Went to the south. What's So it's gonna be somewhere around here. Oh, that's not good. Alright. We'll make this a little bit longer of a normal episode. See if we can get over there in time. Yeah, yeah. Just need to slow him down a little bit. Especially with us going up the hill. Oh. Yeah, they really need to take this mechanic out. I understand that it does add some realism to the game, but this just completely takes away from the fun. I mean, look at this. I can't even get up here. Oh well. What can you do, right? You have a choice. You can either keep playing or you can stop playing. And I'm not stopping playing, so. Just have to live with it. Okay. Oh, chicken, you are so lucky. If you're still here when I come back. You know what? Okay. Oh, this is why I need to get the mini bike done as soon as possible. Which I think I have a good battery. I now have a couple of engines. So the only thing I need are the handlebars, and I don't think I can make those yet. I think I need the handlebar schematic. So I did find the mini bikes for dummies, which is rather funny, but because I have the mini bike, but I don't have any of the things to make the regular handlebars. Which is another thing that I'm not quite sure I agree with. Is that it over there? Yeah, see, it should be somewhere over here. There's so much miscellaneous crap in the game that looks like the airdrops, though. Really need to put that mod in that. Oh, is that it? There's a mod that will keep the streamers going for any of the items, like the airdrops. And I'm thinking I may need to install that, because I hate losing the airdrops. And I always seem to get them only when I have issues with my ankles. Yeah, see, this was a... Oh, right. I'm gonna call it here, and I'm gonna head back, keep working on the base. We need to be ready for the day 14 horde, and we are nowhere close yet. So, yeah. I'm probably gonna go ahead and, because things do... Let me see, we did our last raid, or sweep through the hubs, well, through all of the shops on the 9th day. So... on the 15th day, so yeah, next time we get together, it should be time for the horde, actually. So I will see you all then. If you enjoyed the episode, make sure you hit that like button on your way out. If you haven't done so already, I also do ask that you subscribe. The likes and subscriptions do help the channel to grow, but they also keep you informed on when things are going on around here. And, well, you know me, there's usually something going on around here. Anyway, if you have any questions or comments, throw it down in the section below the video. I do my best to get back to you, but I don't always make it. And if I don't make it, I apologize. I just ran out of time. And as you know, I am out of time, so I'm out of here. I hope you all have a fantastic afternoon and a terrific Friday. With any luck, we will see you. Excuse me. Horrible time for that to happen, huh? Yeah, I was gonna say, hopefully we will see you this evening at the live stream here on YouTube at 7 p.m. U.S. Pacific time. If not, I will hope to see you next week. And if so, I will see you then. Either way, I hope everyone has a fantastic night, and take care, everybody. As always, I'm out of here. Be safe, all.